Hey everyone, I'm Joshua Walquist, one of the editors here at Saturn Hex Media. Today I'd like to go over something I wish I'd known 2 years ago when I was working on my first feature. Today we're going to go over how to put ADR into your scene and make it fit more naturally using only effects found in Premiere Pro. First off, what is ADR? ADR stands for Automated Dialogue Replacement, and unlike the name would suggest, the process is anything but automatic. ADR is primarily used when an actor's line you record on set just isn't clean enough to use in the edit. Let's say a crew member was coughing while the actor was talking, or the location was just too noisy to be able to get a clean recording of. Let's look at this shot as an example.
I'm my mother!
Brilliant, inspired, a true piece of cinematic brilliance. Sound, how was that?
Instead of using the poor quality audio you got on set, you can take the actor and allow them to re-record their lines in a more controlled environment, such as a sound booth or even just a quiet room in your house. ADR isn't anything crazy complicated by itself. Personally, I prefer to give the actors some headphones and let them watch their performance on loop while they try and speak along to it. The real problem comes when you go to put that line into your scene in post.
I'm my mother.
So now that I've brought the ADR into Premiere and lined it up with the original audio on the timeline, you can see that even though the actor's lips line up with the ADR we recorded, it's obvious that he isn't the one saying it. The recording sounds too close to him and doesn't feel natural. There are a couple reasons for this, but without diving too deep into sound theory, let's listen to the original recording and the ADR back to back.
I'm my mother. I'm my mother.
Listening to the two back to back, you can tell that the original recording has just a little bit less bass to it than the ADR has. This is because the microphone was further away from the talent when we recorded the original scene rather than when we recorded the ADR. In addition to that, you can hear the actor's voice bouncing around the room, creating a slight echo effect on the original audio. To fix this, we are going to use two audio effects native to Premiere Pro. First off, in order to replicate the effect of the microphone being slightly further away, we're going to take our ADR and throw a parametric equalizer onto it. Parametric equalizer is a rather intimidating tool at first, but it's actually a lot simpler than it looks. You can see that by default, we have 7 points along the line on this graph. Each point allows you to control the volume of a certain frequency of your audio, and you can fine-tune the variables down below. For what we need to do today, we'll be using the points L and H, which represent the low and high frequencies respectively. All we need to do is take the points and bring them down a little bit. This is where it might be helpful to listen to your playback as you're doing this to get a better idea of exactly where you want it. But I usually find that somewhere around negative 17 decibels for the low frequencies and negative 20 decibels for the high frequencies brings me about where I need to be. Now, let's listen back real quick.
I'm my mother.
It sounds much better, but it still sounds like the actor is right up next to the camera rather than 2 to 3 feet like they actually are. This is where the next effect comes in, convolution reverb. There are a lot of different sliders and ways to fine-tune this tool, but let's save that for a future video. For now, let's leave everything on default and talk about just one of the sliders, mix.
I'm my mother.
Leaving mix on 100%, you can tell that the actor's audio now does have a reverb to it, but it sounds very tinny and artificial. The mix slider allows you to blend the new reverb audio in with the original audio to make it more natural sounding. Usually I find that setting this around 20 to 30% works best for me, but you'll want to play around with it until it feels perfect for your scene.
I'm my mother.
And there we have it. With just 2 effects, you can already tell that the ADR sounds much more natural. Listen to the difference.
I'm my mother. I'm my mother.
Finally, I'm going to show you one last tip in case you need to do this process for a lot of your movie. Over in the effects control panel in Premiere, if you select both effects that we just used with control click and then right click on one of them, we can use the Save Preset button to have these two saved as a simple drag and drop effect, which we can adjust individually when necessary. And there you go, a simple way to make ADR feel more natural and fit into your scene better. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials like this and to keep up with our latest content, and feel free to ask follow-up questions down below in the comments. Till next time, bye.